Hello, welcome to this episode of NLN Podcast Nursing Edge Unscripted. I'm your host, Dr. Stephen Palazzo, a member of the editorial board for Nursing Education Perspectives. In this episode, we will discuss effective retention strategies for Native American nursing students. My guest today is Dr. Cody Bruce. Dr. Bruce is an associate professor at the University of North Texas Health and Sciences Center College of Nursing in Fort Worth, Texas. We will discuss the article promoting retention of Native American nursing students, insights from a qualitative study. This article can be found in the November-December issue of Nursing Education Perspectives. Welcome, Dr. Bruce.
Hi, thank you so much for having me on the program.
Yeah, we're looking forward to your conversation. Let's start off with just how about a description of how the self-determination theory that you used in your study influenced the aims of your study?
So really, as I began looking at Native American nursing students and what kept them in the nursing programs and made them be successful and what led to them not being successful or leaving the program, I really wanted to answer a question of what were those effective retention strategies. And so I really wanted to know what drove those students to complete that degree. And part of that was reviewing a number of theorists, educational theorists that really looked at motivation. And as you well know, and our listeners know, you know, motivation in education is something we've looked at for a long time. Mm-hmm. And mainly we look at grades and financial rewards. And that did not really seem to fit this population. Native Americans have a deep spiritual connection to the earth, to nature, to their being, and especially to their communities. And I knew that many of them wanted to go back and serve their community after they graduated with this degree. This was something that they saw that really wasn't just for them, but was a way to give back. And so it really led me to the self-determination theory because of these kind of intrinsic factors that were leading those students to completion, which was a bit different than the grades and financial rewards that, you know, had been seen in some other publications mm-hmm. that before.
Well, for our listeners, can you describe briefly the self-determination theory and how you found that very useful to look at the aims of your study?
So the self-determination theory really helped describe what the Native American student was experiencing as far as internal motivation factors. Whenever I had conversations with the participants, they were identifying things like outside of financial support and outside of grants and just travel and access to be able to persist. And what they were really centering in on was a sense of belonging, kind okay. of peer networks or social networks that were very unique. Some of the nursing programs actually even had a special Native American nursing entry program. And part of that program was that all of the faculty were trained with cultural safety courses, which helped them develop cultural competency and cultural humility toward Native Americans. And it also connected them with the community that they were serving. So those nursing professors were out in the community and they met the elders of the tribe. Our tribes in the area, and they knew that they were kind of also really cheering on those students to be able to go back and serve in those communities. Some of the other things that really kind of aligned well with the self-determination theory was this idea of giving back,
okay.
where a student would return back to the reservation. And one student even pointed out that they wanted to break this cycle that was happening in their reservation, which was when people would leave and would be possibly successful at getting an education, they would never return, that the very best of their tribe would become educated, and because of lack of resources and job opportunities there, they would not come back except for social or family events. So they weren't in the community and supporting the community any longer. So several of the nursing students really talked about they wanted to work within their reservation system at the Indian Health Service clinics or hospitals that were run there to treat their own families in their own community. And that they realized that that was a significant decision because it determined, financial implications, because a lot of those small clinics did not pay as well in those areas as it would in a larger city. However, the students wanted to be close to their families, and they knew that that was of great importance to not only themselves, but also if they had children. So that was a really huge motivating factor, because the students that had children that I interviewed, their extended family were caring for them while they were in nursing, caring for their children while they were in nursing school. So they knew that that family model was just very important and central.
Right. So, from the work of your study, what would you recommend if you just had one strategy to recommend? And I know it's multifactorial and there's more than one strategy and it's much more complicated than that. But for our listeners, if you had one strategy to promote retention for Native American nursing students, what would that be?
Well, I think it's really important to get to know the students. You have to know the community you serve. And as nurses, I think we all know that to some degree, that your population at one hospital will be very different than if you're a community nurse in another setting. And I would say if you are a nursing professor or a nurse that's working in a hospital that's precepting students, I would say get to know the community that you're serving, whether they're Hispanic or if they are Native American. And so I would say that first strategy would be get to know the community. As you know the community, you're also going to unknowingly be invested in that community. And if you have, one big strategy that you could take forward with students is allowing them to see someone that is like them in the role. That was the number one takeaway from my study, was that the students really valued seeing another Native American in the role of professor, in the role of a preceptor, or just a registered nurse that the faculty brought in from the community to help talk about heart failure in this clinic that they worked in, or that they were a diabetic nurse, or just different issues that they were seeing within that population. One really great program that one of my students described was, I think this was in South Dakota State University. The student said that they have a program where the nursing students that were Native American, let's say they probably had about 10 nursing students that were Native American. They partnered with the community health nursing faculty, and they actually went to the tribe. The whole class went to the tribe and would do assessments with the elders and that community. So, in order to prepare the non-Native American students to be able to know those cultural norms out in the Native American community, those 10 Native American students became the leaders of that course.
Oh,
And they
wonderful. Got it.
actually taught the other students, what to expect, how to show respect to the elders, what to do if you're offered something. Things like maintaining eye contact, all those very important things that are so nuanced in various communities. And so that was their really contribution to that community assessment project. And they were seen as leaders, not only in that one course, but to their entire cohort, because they were addressing and even giving back to their own community.
That's great. And you bring up a great point about students wanting to see others like them in faculty roles. And as we know, nursing in general, and more specifically, nursing education is very heterogeneous as far as faculty are concerned. And it's important also that I think we have conversations with students about coming back to nursing education to be one of those people that represent an other, somebody who looks different or is different, you know, is a, I don't want to say is different, but you know, has a, is representing a broader perspective than our traditional nursing faculty. And it really does make a difference. I know in universities I've been at, when we have faculty of color, or we have faculty of that are men, LGBTQI faculty, it makes a difference to students to see those role models. And the work you're doing is very important in better understanding how students can rise up and be leaders and also represent their culture, their ethnicity, their perspective.
One thing I may also mention to our listeners is not all Native Americans are the same.
Right.
And each tribe is so individualized, and the historic trauma that each tribe has experienced is similar. It's a thread that is shared across all of Native America. But I think it's important to know that just because you're looking at someone that may have pale or white, lighter colored skin, isn't to assume that they are not Native American.
Right.
Also, if you have someone with really, really darker skin, it, you know, not assuming that they're African American, because they could very well be Native American and be part of a tribe. And so I think it's important to ask our clients, our patients, our students, you know, what do you identify as? Because I myself am Native American from the Choctaw Apache tribe in Louisiana, and I'm very fair skinned. And so it is often, you know, assumed that I'm not Native American, but I have been a member of the tribe, you know, since birth. And so one of the things, this is one of the messages that I think people are trying to get out there as well, is to ask people how they identify, as well as their respected, if they're LGBTQ. And certainly one other aspect that is unique to being a Native American is a newer term to many listeners may be indigiqueer or two-spirit. And that is, those two terms identify Native Americans that are from the LGBTQIA community. And so those may be a couple of terms that you hear in some of your interactions with students. So I just wanted to share that.
I think that's great. And I think you bring up a wonderful point, right? A great life lesson is never make assumptions. and, you know, our everyday, you know, we make assumptions about lots of things, but it's important not to make those assumptions and clarify those assumptions. You know, Dr. Bruce, I want to thank you for joining us for this important conversation. Your expertise has helped broaden our understanding of some of this work and gives us some insight in how we can introduce this at our own institutions. And to our listeners, if you have not had the opportunity, please look for Dr. Bruce's work promoting retention of Native American nursing students, insights from a qualitative study in the November-December issue of Nursing Education Perspectives. And I want to thank you again, Dr. Bruce, for joining us and sharing your information with us.
Thank you very much.